before, move in a dimension like no other time before. We know that you are here. We know that you are here to deliver us, to heal us. Holy Spirit, we acknowledge your presence in our midst. Holy Spirit, we know you are here. We worship you. We thank you. We praise you. We surrender all our praise unto you. We worship you. We bless your holy name. Father, visit each and every one of us this morning. Visit each and every one of us this morning. That we shall not go back home the same way. We thank you, Father. We thank you for your manifest presence in our midst. Holy Spirit of the living God, we invite you. Move like no other time before. Say, Kerie Bobo Zenderie Baba Horia Baba. Mafi Kandada Barika Kaproshka. Mandoro Ripo Santa. Ripo Santa, say, Kerie Bobo. Rika kaproshka manda praka sekerie bobo rabasata rishota kamaye horia baba mafi kandanaba sekerie bobo. Father, we worship. We welcome you in our midst. We welcome you in our midst. Take absolute control. Take absolute charge. That we say and do, we shall be guided by you. Holy Spirit of the living God, we know you are here. We know you are here to heal us. We know you are here to release that testimony. We know you are here. Of the living God. We know you are here for our breakthroughs. Touch each and every one of us. Visit each and every one of us in our areas of need. Perfect each and every area of our life that needs your divine touch. In our finances, oh God. In our ministry. In our businesses. In our careers. Visit us, oh God. Heal us. That we may not go back home the same way. But if I followed us to church this morning, heal us, oh God. Deliver us from all forms of bondage. Deliver us from all forms of captivity. Holy Spirit, have your way. Have your way. Move mightily. Like no other time before. We thank you for this opportunity to come into your presence. Touch each and every one of us. Visit us. Visit us, oh God. As a family, as a ministry, as individuals. Each and every one of us. Deliver us from all forms of bondage. From all forms of captivity. Holy Spirit, we adore you. We worship you. We thank you in advance for our deliverance. We thank you in advance that captives are being set free. We thank you because we are working with our testimonies. We thank you that this is a moment of breakthrough. We thank you that we are progressing. By your name we cast out demons. In the name of Jesus, we are set free. No demon will stand your way. No demon will stand in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Touch us, oh God. Heal us, oh God. Let every power in the name of Jesus surrender unto you.
Lusa, let her go. Lusa, now let her go. It's every stranger. Fire of the Holy Spirit. From the head to the toes. From the shoe to the ring to the clothes. I command your deliverance now. Now. By the fire of the Holy Spirit. Lusa, let her go. Who are you? Of Jesus. Are you enjoying the service or? You come here to watch with this body? Who are you? Okay, I command the Holy Ghost fire on the floor. Fire on the floor. Fire in the shoe. Fire in the clothes. Fire in the air, all over you, right now. Every stranger around this body, I put you in the captivity right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire. Hey, who are you? Who are you? Who are you?
Hey, Auntie, we want to kill you. We want to kill you. And the son also now.
You want to kill who? Huh? Are you talking to me or you are talking to this body? Who are you talking to? You going to kill who?
Yeah, I wanted this lady to kill.
Why do you want to kill them? Why do you want to kill them?
They want money.
Eh? You want their money or what do you say? Okay. Who are you? A what?
Her auntie.
Her auntie. Yeah. You don't have name?
We are waiting for you.
You don't have name? What is your name? You stranger. I'm asking you a question by the fire of the Holy Ghost.
Leave me.
What is your
leave
mission?
Me.
Eh? I will leave you when you leave this body. What is your mission in this body?
Bring your son first. Hmm? I'll tell you. Bring your son. We want to kill them both now.
Where is the son? Bring the son. Come here. Mm-hmm. You come here. Come here. Hey, you stranger. Behave. I called the Legion of the Fire. Look, who is this? Who is this one? Who is this? I command you in the mighty name of Jesus. Speak as I ask you. Who is this? You want them both to die? So, you want money?
Yeah.
So, do you want to use two of them for money? Are you a ritualist? How long have you been in this body?
What do you think? From 2011.
Eh? Eh?
From 2011.
From 2011.
She's supposed to suffer.
How did you enter here? How did you enter this body? How did you enter this family? Okay, your time is over. Look, who is this? Behave. Hear me. Who is this? Look at this. Who is this? You don't know him? Who is this one? You don't know him? Hey, who are you? You say you don't see. This one says you don't know you. Speak. Who are you? Who are you?
Cutler.
Huh? Who is this?
My mom.
Huh?
Linky.
Huh?
Linky.
Linky. Your mommy. tell her that you are, this is your mommy. Speak to her.
You are my mother.
Eh?
No.
It's not your son.
No, I don't have a baby.
You don't have a baby. So who is this one? Who is this one? You don't know.
What do you think you are?
Eh?
You are going to save them.
Yes.
You want them now. What do you think you are?
Uh-huh. I'm a son of God. I'm a son of God. And whoever the son of God is set free, they are free. So I'm going to set the two of them free. And you, I'm going to send you to hellfire, where you come from. Now, in the name of Jesus, leave her. By the fire of the Holy Ghost. By the fire of the Holy Ghost. Out of this body. Now. Fire! 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 Out of this body! Holy Ghost fire! Down! Down! In the name of Jesus! Out of her now! You tormentor of this body! Out! Yes! Out! 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 Take out your instrument! Take them off! Take them off! Take them off! Take them off! All your instruments of death! Take them off! 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 Set her free! Set her free! Set the soul free! Now, on the floor, your back on the floor. Come here! Your back on the floor. Your back on the floor. By the fire of the Holy Spirit, now your time is over, you stranger. Holy Spirit, by the fire of the Holy Spirit, fire on your cloth, fire on your shoe, fire in your hand, Holy Ghost fire, in your cloth, in your hand, Holy Ghost fire, in your cloth, in your feet, in your body, all over, fire, 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 Holy Ghost fire, set her free. Daughter, come. Let's
Jesus.
Go. How are you? Yes, you're free. Yes, come.
Something happens.
Hallelujah. Come, my boy.
When I call your name.
My daughter, who is this?
My son.
Your son? Who is she? Who is he?
Son.
Your son. Amen. Are you sure it's your son? You sure? This is your son?
My one and only.
Your one and only? Oh, I thought you said it's not your son. You said it's not your son.
No, we came.
You came together? Sure. Okay, hug your son. No more death. No more death. No more death. Amen.
Jesus.
Hey, you. Come here. Okay. No, just wait. I can see she's enjoying my service. Anne, you are enjoying my service.
Okay.
You are enjoying my service.
Jesus.
I welcome you. I command fire in your tear. It's nice to see. Nice to sit, ne? Enjoying or watching? Okay. So now, since you want to enjoy my service, I welcome you with the fire of the Holy Ghost on the chair, on the clothes, on the shoe, in your body, on the hair, all over, in the shoe, in the floor. And you are welcome now. Enjoy the seat. Enjoy it when it lasts. Every package is here. Every essence. Fire! Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! Aha! She's enjoying the chair now, so let her enjoy very well. Fire, fire, fire all over the body. From the head to the toes. From the finger to the ring. To the shoe. To the ear. In the water. Yes, yes, yes. Catch it, catch it. Catch it, catch it. Catch it, catch it. Catch it, catch it, catch it. Catch it, catch it. In the chair. Fire, 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 fire. Hey, on the floor, 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 on the feet, on the feet, on the feet. Fire, 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 fire. Aha, aha, fire. Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire. Enjoy it, Holy Ghost fire. Yes, yes. Holy Ghost fire. Give me the blood. Uh-huh. You say you are enjoying. Enjoy my seat. I welcome you. Welcome you with the fire. I welcome you with the fire. I welcome you with the fire. I welcome you. I welcome you. Hey, organize yourself. Be far. Holy Ghost fire. 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 Lusa. Fire. Fire in the zoo. In the bed. In the bed. In the ring. In the here, every ornament catch fire. Every ornament catch fire. Every strange object catch fire. Every strange object catch fire. Fire. Aha. Show yourself. Who are you? Hey, don't distract me. Show yourself. Show yourself now. Show yourself. Show yourself. Show yourself. Show yourself. Show yourself. Command your liberty. Command your liberty. Fire of the Holy Spirit. Fire of the Holy Spirit. I said, show yourself. Where are you from? Yes. Show yourself. Manifest. Show yourself. Show yourself. Show yourself. Show yourself. Where are you from? Where are you from? Show yourself. You don't want to look at my shoe. My shoes carry fire now. But you also have your shoe. Show yourself now. Fire. Get out of her. Get out of her. Uh-huh. Show yourself. Because you follow this body, I'm separating you and this body. You stranger, I'm separating you. Where are you from? You satanic ocean spirit. Which kingdom are you from? Speak! Which kingdom are you from?
Why are you always praying for?
Huh? She's my daughter. And you have to separate yourself from her. She's my daughter. Separate yourself from her now. Are you ready to go? Leave her.
Just because of you.
Huh?
It's because of you.
Uh-huh. What have I done?
For the time she's telling to stay.
What have I done now?
Everything she has is because of you.
Mm-hmm. Because of God, it's not because of me.
That's why I was separated from you.
Ah? Ah? So you have the power to separate my own daughter from me.
Anytime she comes to you, things go for her. You always deliver her.
And you don't want her to be delivered.
I'm her uncle.
You are uncle. You don't have name.
You are not part of our family. Leave her alone. Leave her alone.
What is your mission, you wicked uncle? Why are you tormenting her? You wicked uncle, why are you tormenting her?
I want to destroy her.
What have you destroyed? Since you want to destroy her, what have you destroyed? What have you done to her marriage?
She feels tired.
What have you done to her business?
I want to scatter everything. Everything. Everything.
So you are a scatterer. Why? Why? You are uncle to her. Why
She's
are you doing
very,
this?
Very, very bright. Her parents are not asking of anything from me because of her. She's always buying everything. Everything for her. For the mother, everything she has is because of her. I made the father to be sick.
You made the father to be sick.
Now the father cannot do anything, but she's now doing everything for them. I want to destroy her business. I want to destroy her. I want to destroy her. Everything about her.
You want to destroy everything about her? Why can you destroy what God has not destroyed? Now I command the Holy Ghost fire upon that uncle, wherever you are. I command the Holy Ghost fire upon that uncle. Okay. What power and how are you disturbing her? How are you operating in her? Get out of her. Your time is over. Whatever poison you have given her, vomit it now. Vomit it now. By the fire of the Holy Ghost. One, I count seven for you. Seven, and everything you have destroyed, restore them, because it's our month of restoration. One, two, three, four, five. If at the count of seven you don't leave everything, I will send legions of fire into your camp. Six, take off every garment. Take it off, take it off, take it off. Every spirit of death, every spirit of failure, take them out, take them out, take them out. Now you foul spirit, you wicked uncle, I command you in the mighty name of Jesus, get out of this body. Fire out, 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 out. Loose her, let her go in the name of Jesus. Come and give the Lord a clap for our freedom. It is done. You come here. You. Come and give the Lord a clap of everybody. Let's take our seat. The service continue. The service continue. Let's take our seat. Let's take our seat. Come on. Hallelujah.
Father, we thank you for what you have done. We thank you, oh God, for this awesome visitation. We thank you, Lord. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Let us quickly turn to the book of people of God.
Of Jesus, you are kings and queens of the Lord. Ye are prince and princess of the Lord. And I have never seen a queen or a king or a prince and princess living in the sack or begging for food. Today, wherever enemy has put you among the commoners, whatever situation has put you among the commoners, God asked me to tell you, He has set the chronicle of remembrance towards you. You are leaving your place of commoner to your royal palace. Just as Esther left the house of the commoners to her royal palace, you are leaving your house of commoner to your house of royalty, to your house of honor, to your house of dignity, in the mighty name of Jesus. Please be seated. Worship team, the world will hear your voice. The world will hear your voice, in the mighty name of Jesus. I celebrate you all. Amen. Come and give the Lord a clap offering. For all those testimony that we have heard, give the Lord a clap offering for them. People of God, it's not about the crowd. In fact, we are the crowd. You don't have focus. In the crowd, there are no focus. Because in the 10,000 crowd, there are 9,000 onlookers. I want you to be fully persuaded that this service is for you, not for those that are not here. It's for you that are here. Say, this service is for me, in the name of Jesus. Before I go deeply, I want to quickly remind you that the essence of Sunday service is to go before the Lord for restoration. Why do people go to the clinic? Why do people go to health center? It's because they want their health to be restored. So also, we have gathered here this morning for our own spiritual and physical restoration. You shall be restored. Whatever the enemy has stolen in your life. And in a moment, the Lord just showed me that, you know what, son? To restore people means they are being restored to where they were. He said, there might be no glory. He said, but restoration with reformation brings more glory. The Lord just told me that. He said, when I restore people, I restore them with reformation. Say reformation. Say restoration with reformation. Restoration with decoration. That's my portion. Say, that's my portion. Say, that's my portion. How many of you desire to be restored? Let me see your hand. How many of you desire to be reformed? Let me see your hand. How many of you desire to be decorated? Hallelujah. It's going to happen this month. It's going to happen this month. Why? Let me quickly remind you why. Ezekiel 24, verse 1. Ezekiel 24, verse 1. And I will be reminding you this word. Let's read now. One, two, go. Hello? Brother George, where is the King George? Is he around? Okay. Now let's read one, two, go. Say again. Say it louder. Yes. In the 10th day of the month. Verse 2. Verse 27. In that day, it is escape. And thou shalt speak, and be no more dumb. And thou shalt be a sign unto them, and they shall know that I am the Lord. I am the Lord, thy lady. I am the Lord, your healer. I sent my way to be your disease. I am the Lord, the healer. I am the Lord.
I am the Lord,
the healer. Yes, yes. The Lord, my healer. Yes, Lord, he said,
you sent his word to heal my disease. I am the Lord, your healer.
Studio. And as I was memorizing, as I was thinking, as I was discussing with the Lord gave me a song of the month. And I want you to listen to this. Remember me Almighty God. Put me in remembrance, O Lord, in your restoration agenda in this latter end of the year. Put me in your remembrance. Make me a sign. Make me a testimony in this latter year agenda. Holy Spirit, I ask of you. Change my story from this service today. Restore me. Decorate me. And change my story as you have changed others, let it be my tongue. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we have prayed. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. I'm in the spirit of worship today. I just want to let God know that by all means, I am available. I am eager for his touch. I am available. My heart, my mind, my spirit opens for his touch of remembrance. There is a song that is coming to my heart again. I don't know it very well. It's a song in my dialect. You know where I came from? From Limpopo. We sing so many songs there. Om taye tiga lowo mi baba ba mi da won pada oluwa ye olu orun o da won pada fun mi ye ye olu orun da won pada fun mi o. You know it? Sing it. Oh. Stand up and sing it. Tell you what that song is saying. That song is crying unto the Lord that, oh God of Almighty, whatever and everything that the world has stolen from me, oh Lord God of heaven, saying, restore them back to me. Yeah, oh Lord, thou art God for me. Whatever the world has stolen from you, whatever you have lost, heaven will restore them to you today. 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 In the name of... Please be seated. In the next few minutes, we'll be rounding up the service. But I want you to go home with an assurance of the Lord. If this is month, if this is our month, if it's our season of restoration, how would the Lord restore me? Put me into remembrance. If this is our season of restoration, how would the Lord restore me? God said, put me into remembrance. What do you want to be restored? You hear that, daughter? She was so convinced in her spirit that that business in a compound we grow because the man of God has said it, because the prophet of the Lord has said it. So she kept reminding the Lord that you will not disappoint the word of your prophet. So even when everybody was against her, she held on to the prophet agenda. God said, go there. She went, and I remember vividly. So many years back. How can you tell somebody to close the shop in the city and now go to Very, where is that place? Eh? Best Valley. Best Valley is contradict. I mean, and you saw people who come there they will be training. But by the word of the prophet, by the agenda of the Lord concerning her, when people say, no, you are stupid, he said, no. The man of God said it. She kept reminding them. It's not too late also for you to remind the Lord, whatever God has promised you. However, I want you to know something. That no matter how long Satan has defrauded you, no matter how deep enemy has defrauded you, today it is your turn. It is your turn to defraud the Satan. It is your turn to defraud the enemy, because you are moving from mockery to testimony. I bring you a good tidings. The Lord asked me to speak to people under the sound of my voice right now, that no more mockery in your life. Say no more mockery. Say no more mockery in my life. Today, I will settle it with God. No more mockery. No more mockery in my life. People of God, what is mocking you? Satan has stolen your marriage, and now your faith mock. Say enough. Satan has stolen your property, and you are being mocked. Say enough. Satan has stolen your career, your business, and people are mocking you. Say enough. This service is for you. Bring me into remembrance. Put me in remembrance. Let us plead together. Declare that thou mayest be justified. I just want us to argue three cases with God this morning. And then we will settle it and ask him to restore. As he restored these three people. Number one, I want you to know, in the agendas of restoration, I want you to be fully persuaded that if he has said it, that he will restore you, because he has remembered you, he will do it. How would he do it? He did it before. With who? He did it with Job. Job chapter 19, verse 19. Job 19, verse 19. Let's read it together. All my inward friends abhor me, and they whom I loved are turned against me. Say mockery. Say mockery. I don't know what mockery you are going through. God sent me specifically today to tell you that your mockery is over. Say to your neighbor, neighbor, your mockery is over. Say, neighbor, your mockery is over from today. People of the Lord, in the season of remembrance, I want you to be fully persuaded that whatever mockery in your life, God has come in your remembrance for your restoration. Job was a man like me and you, and everybody mocked him. Every what? Everybody, including his wife. I don't know who is mocking you. Your husband, your wife, your friends, your ex-husband, your ex-friend, your colleague. I don't know how they are mocking you. I want you to wake up from this service today and stop mocking yourself. And what? Stop mocking yourself. They mock Job. They mock Job. My close friends detest me. what? They hate him. And those that he loves, they turn against him. I'm still in Job 19, verse 19. Job 19, verse 19. They turn against him. People of God, when things are not going well, it looks like God has forgotten you. Upon that, people begin to mock you. You are 50 years now, you are 40 years now, you are 30 years now, there is no child, there is no marriage, there is no business, there is no work. As if it's not enough, people begin to mock you. I have good news for you if you are under the sound of my voice. Don't let anybody mock you. God has come down for you. Because you are here, because I am here, because the Holy Spirit is here, he asked me to tell you, your season of mockery is over. I say your season of mockery is over. No matter how many people look at you, say, look at her. As beautiful as she is, she has no husband. As handsome as he is, he has no wife. Please, after this service today, when they mock you, tell them, my God has remembered me. Everyone that is mocking you, they are reminding God for you. Do you hear what I said? Everyone that is mocking you, all that are mocking you, they are reminding God to remember you. And my God will remember you. That's why we are singing that song. Remember me, Almighty God. Oh, remember
me, Almighty God.
There are pastors that are hearing me now. People are mocking them. But as many mouths that are mocking them, they are reminding God about them. You that are under the sound of my voice in this auditorium, every 10 person that mock you are helping your prayer to be answered. I'm talking about you. So don't give yourself down to mockery, because after your mockery, it is your testimony. I say it is your testimony. What happened? Job 12, verse 4. When the Lord turned the mockery of Job, let's read together. I am as one mocked of his neighbor. Hey! Did you see what I saw? Your neighbor is mocking you now. Your colleague in the office are mocking you. You are not alone. Job said, I am as one mocked by his neighbor like you. Excuse me, look at the person sitting next to you. Look at that person. A male or female. Look at the one behind you. Look at the one in front of you. I am telling you the truth. Each of these people you are seeing here now, they are mocking you. That's the truth. Hello? That's the truth. The person in front of you or behind you, because you didn't see him or you didn't see her, she's doing like this to you. In fact, every time you are singing, Hosanna, 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 he's doing like this. Instead of him or her singing, what she's doing like this. Hosanna. You know, you are the, how many finger did you raise when you are praising? Five. Making how many? 10. But can I tell you the truth? The moment the person behind you begin to do like this, Hosanna. He has added that many finger to you. The one behind you has added many. The one behind you has added many. They have helped you. About 50 hands is now standing down. Look at her. Oh. Look at her. Oh. Look at her. Oh. For visitation. For restoration. Come on. Say, I refuse to be mocked. they are reminding God of me. All his neighbor, they mock him. And he answered him, the just upright man is laughed to scorn. He said, Job, you, Wena, you are still going to whine me. You are still going to that church. They are adding more cloud for the Lord to remember you. Say, let them mock me. My God will make me. And when the story of Job changed, Job chapter 42, verse 10, this is what's going to happen in your life. And the Lord turned the captivities of Job when he prayed for his friends. Also, the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. So this is why God said to me, son, restoration make no testimony. But restoration with decoration brings what? Testimony. If they sack you now as a secretary and they restore you as a secretary, there is no glory there. But when they sack you as a secretary, they restore you as a manager. Say no more mockery in my life. Say no more mockery in my life. My daughter was driving one scorro, Old Testament. And she keep turning herself. She keep turning the Old Testament. Old Testament, listen, I'm doing you a favor for riding you. But after a while, every time she's coming to church, the Old Testament will stop on the road, mocking her. But the Lord said, this same Old Testament will be mocked one day. Today, every situation mocking your life shall be mocked. Every situation mocking your life, they shall be mocked. Why? The Lord turned the captivities of Job. He waited unto the Lord on a particular day. God make all his mockery to be his what? To be his friends. And the Lord restored Job's prosperity in another fashion and gave him twice as much he had before. Say, that's number one. Oh God, remember. Say, oh God, remember Job, how you restore him and how you decorated him. How you remember him. Now it's my turn. Say, Lord, let me remind you again how you turned the life of Mephibosheth. God says, show me. 2 Samuel chapter 9. Let's go there. 2 Samuel chapter 9. We read from verse 3, 4, and 5. Let's read together. One, two, go. And the king said, is there not yet any of the house of Saul that I might show the kindness of God unto him? And Ziba said unto king, Jonathan had yet a song which is lame on his feet. Yes, let's go. Verse 4. And the king said unto him, where is he? The son of Amir in Lodibah. Verse 5. Then king sent and fetched him out of the house of the Lodibah. Verse 13. So Mephibosheth dwelt in Jerusalem, for he did it continually at the king's table and was lame on both his feet. Mephibosheth was a son of mockery. Mephibosheth was who? A son of Mockery. But when God remembered him, Mephibosheth was lame. Mephibosheth was handicapped. People of God, this is where I'm going. I don't know the handicapping condition that is making people to mock you. You know what's handicapping condition? It's not only in physical disability, in financial disability, people mock you. I don't know what make your life crippled, and people are mocking you. I have good news for you. When the king entered the house, he asked, "Is there not yet another person?" Mephibosheth did not announce himself. Mephibosheth did not announce himself. He has no capacity, he has no power to announce himself. But on the days of remembrance, say on the day of my remembrance, say on the day of my remembrance, my disability will announce me. Say it, on the day of remembrance, my disability will announce me. Ah, they said that boy. Yes, yes, there is another one. That guy, who is lame? Oh, who is lame? We need him. Your disability of today, I said it will announce you. It will bring you to your remembrance in the mighty name of Jesus. So God remember my people say, not by his ability. Not by what? His ability. But by his disability. I'm saying to you also, people of the Lord, whatever disability condition you find yourself right now is the reason why God will remember you. So, stop crying and weeping in your disability condition. Stop crying and weeping in your rejected, lonely condition. God, you know I have no car. How can I travel now? God, you know I have no bank account. You know I have no money. How can I buy a car? How can I buy a house? God, you know I have no salary. God, you know I have no job. Then, how can I afford this? How can I do that? In your disability, that is why God will announce you and will remember you. I'm speaking life to your situation this morning. It is your season of remembrance. It is your season of remembrance in the mighty name of Jesus. Riches was in your situation. Genesis chapter 30, verse 1 and 2. Genesis chapter 30, we read verse 1 and verse 2. One to go. And when Rachel saw that she bare Jacob no children, Rachel envied her sister and said unto Jacob, "Give me children, or else I die." This is a very serious situation. Verse 2. And Jacob's anger was kindled against Rachel. And he said, what's your problem now? Am I in God's stead? Am I God? Who had withheld thee from the fruit of the womb? This is a very critical situation. I want you to listen to me very carefully. When a man and a woman in a state of mockery, everything mock him. Everything mock her. Even Jacob and Rachel. Even the husband begin to mock the wife. Amen. The wife begin to mock the husband. When the man is going through a state of testimony, people will mock you. Amen. Hello? Are you hearing me what I'm saying? When you are about to be launched into your testimony, people will mock you. Please, in your state of mockery, don't bury yourself, because they are helping God to take you to your testimony. Ah, Jacob said to Rachel, what's my problem now? You know the way you also shout at your friend, the way you shout at people. Let me do you. Let me kill you. Waiting now. You know my brothers from the other side. You know what I'm talking about. You mock your friend. Even wife mock. Even daughter and son. A daughter, sons mock parents. Hey, daddy, mommy. Yeah, I remember one time when Faithful was still 4 years. When we are living our own mukuku. When we are living our own mukuku. Where when it is raining, we will push bed to one side. Then rain will be. I'm telling you the truth, people of the Lord. Before God that I serve, when it is raining, rain will be dropping by our own bed. We'll be dropping by the other side. And then we have to wake up and look for another position to put favor. And then the rain is dropping at our own bed. So by the time we push and push and push, rain is left and right. We'll only be praying for the for morning, so that we go and carry cattle and put them on the floor. Then Favor said to me one day, she's big girl now, she won't remember she said it. She said, Daddy, is this our London? Because when I was leaving my country, we told them that Daddy is going to London. And actually, I was going to London. This is the truth. I was not meant for here. God kept me here because of all of you hearing me now. God kept me here because of you people. Sit down under the sound of my voice now. I would have been in Dublin. I would have been where? I would have been in Dublin. I was going to Dublin. Let me tell you the story. I was going to Dublin. I was just on a transit from South Africa. And when I get to South Africa, I did an interview. And when I did the interview, they asked me that, are you speaking French or you are speaking English? I was doing an interview or video conference to go to Republic of Ireland to go and make Pakistani. I would have been very rich. I'm telling you, the people of the Lord. My business is very lucrative, if you want to know. So, after the interview, first time in my life, I will be doing interview with the white people. Not even face to face. On TV. Say, Pastor Tau, you are joking. Say, Pastor Tau, you are joking. Say it now. Say, Pastor Tau, you are joking. God brought you to South Africa for me. It's because of you that I didn't go to Dublin. You will have been looking for me in Dublin by now. So Favor said, Daddy, is this our London? Let's go back to Nigeria now. This woman cried, Daddy. I said, so why are you crying now? She said, baby now. She said, baby. She said, but it's true now. Can we be? We have 3 bedrooms there. After the mockery, even now, hear me now, people of the Lord. Just 2 days ago, the same Favor. I'm now buying the ticket. I was buying their ticket or planning their visa for Sengay. The same Favor. Said, Daddy, where are we going in December now? I said, of course we are now London. London again? The same Favor. Do you hear what I'm saying? London again? Every time, London, 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 London. Every time, Europe, Europe, Europe. Why not another, America, Canada? I say, But that day you are asking me, is this our London? Say, God will turn your mockery to your story. Jacob said to his wife, Am I God? That's high level of mockery. But let's see what happened in verse 22. Verse 22. After his, her own husband even mocked her. After your friend has been mocking you. Before you came to church this morning. Your family has been mocking you. Genesis chapter 30 verse 22. Let's see what happened. One, two, go. And God, remember Rachel. And God, hake it to her. And open the womb. God is opening your womb this morning. God is opening your womb. Everywhere the enemy has marked you. God is opening your womb. God is remembering you. In the name of Jesus. The husband said, in few hours, in few days, am I God? So that's why I told you, many people, as many people that mock you, they are helping you to remember God. To remind God why you must bless this guy. Because you are a subject of testimony. Jacob said, am I your God? Ah, God heard him. You are mocking my daughter. Why are you mocking my sons and daughter? And God, remember her because of the mockery of the husband. The mockery of your friends. The mockery of your family. This morning has brought God to remember you. And God remember Rachel. Finally, Jesus himself became a mockery. Jesus himself became a mockery. Matthew 27 verse 31 and verse 35. Read. And after that they had mocked him. They took the robe off for him and put his own raiment on him and led him away to crucify him. Verse 35. And they crucified him and parted his garment, casting lots. Verse 37. And set up over his head his accusation written, this is Jesus, the King of the Jews. Verse 41. Likewise also the chief priest mocking him. Verse 41. Likewise also the chief priest mocking him. I want you to show you what is happening there. The multitude mock him. Even people that are nobody, they mock him. The chief priest mock him. They said, look at him. He said he's a pastor of thousands, but now he's pastoring 100. You didn't see a pastor. You didn't see a dicky. You didn't see a dickness. He says God called him for prosperity. Look at his shoe. Look at her shoe. They mock him. They mock Jesus. Hey, look at him. He says he's a healer. But he can't heal himself on that cross. He says he's a deliverance. But he can't deliver himself. They mock him. Luke 22 verse 63. And the men that heard Jesus mock him. Read it. And the men that heard Jesus mocked him and smote him. Woman, this is for you. Even men men that are in your life, they mock you. What else? What else? But in the state of this mockery, God will remember you. I say, God will remember you. And Luke 23, verse 11 says, and Herod with his men of war set him at naught, and they mock him. I'm saying to you. And then Luke 23, verse 34, verse 36. Say what? And the soldiers also, do you hear that? And the soldiers also mock him, coming to him and offering him vinegar. When a man is in the state of mockery, people give you anything. They give you dirty slap. They give you dirty words. They use dirty language at you. I know right now your heart is sore of people that have been mocking you. But after this service this morning, I want you to rejoice. I want you to rejoice. The same Jesus, because this is what's going to be happening now. And I'm going to give you the final solution. Hebrews chapter 12. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2. What does the Bible say? How did Jesus overcome the mockery? Let's see together. Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, woo, for the joy that was set before him, endured the cross, despising the shame, despising all the mockery, and he sat down at the right hand of the throne of the Lord. They mock him. Say, everybody mock him. Say, everybody mock him on the cross. The cross was his own transformation to his own glory. Everybody is mocking you today because of your own cross, because of the situation you are going through. Jesus was only going through the cross. He was not living by the cross. I'm saying to you, sons and daughter, you are only going through it for your own transformation. I don't know how many people mock you in this journey. It's going to be a very short journey because it's coming to an end today. Am I speaking to somebody here? I don't care how many family, even husband, mock Rachel. I don't care, even the soldiers, that is the government, they mock Jesus. Even Mephibosheth, they call him name. In the first instance, they didn't say, oh, Mephibosheth. They said, that lame guy, that was his name. They call him. They didn't even call him his name. Some of you, they've forgotten your name. So people call you, that barren woman. They call you a man of limb. Hello. Whatever limb they call you, amen, does not matter with what the Lord call you. Amen. Whatever the limb they call you, it doesn't matter to what the Lord call you. Rise upon your feet, everybody. I want you to endure. The man of God was teaching us this morning the waiting period of the Lord. Your waiting period is over. You are crossing over. Say, my waiting period is over. Say it louder. Say it louder. I am crossing over. My waiting period is over. I am crossing over from my mockery to my testimony. I am crossing over. I'm crossing over to a new life, to a new beginning, to a new progress, to a new success, to a new marriage, to a new business, to a new career, to a new job. My mockery is over. my mockeries are over because I am crossing over from my mockery to my testimony. Jesus, cross over from mockery to testimony. Mephibosheth, cross over from mockery to testimony. Rachel, cross over from mockery to testimony. It is my turn. It is my turn. Come and give the Lord a clap offering. Begin to say unto the Lord, Lord, it is my time. Remember me, O God. It is my time. Remember me in my mockery. People are mocking me. Come and clap your hands to the Lord and begin to remind the Lord. People are mocking me. People are mocking my life. People are mocking my marriage. People are mocking my career. People are mocking my head. It is my time. I am crossing over. Come and lift up your hands and begin to pray to the Lord. Lord. Something is going to happen right now. Hear this one. I'm launching you by fire of the Holy Ghost. Due to your own testimony. Matthew 28. I read verse 1 and verse 2. Something is going to happen now. There is going to be an eruption. There is going to be an earthquake. There is going to be a sudden transformation. There is going to be a sudden visitation of remembrance right now. In your life, in your situation, in your circumstances. Matthew 28, verse 1. Something happened. Something happened. Something happened. Now I know it touched me. Yes, 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 yes. It touched me. Yes! Capra, so take it in. Oh, yes, the child of Lord. This, the scripture said that in the end of the Sabbath, in the end of the Sabbath, in the end of this service that you are in, as it began to dawn towards the first day of the week, the first day of the week, Monday, Mary and the other Mary to see the second part. Verse 2. What happened? What happened? Read it for me. Verse 2. Everybody. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. After the end of the service, after the end of the service, as he entered onto the Monday to go in for the business, there was a quake that said, Jesus, the heaven remember him. In fact, the Jews, they said to the king, did you remember that he said he will wake up? And when they began to mock him, God remember him in the grave. He said, okay, the mockery is over. They said, let's go so that we can mock him. Are you still there? But when they got there, say when they get there, say when they got there, say when they call me, when they call me after this service to mock me, I am no more there. Oh, he touched me. after this service, they suddenly saw me with what? When they call me jobless woman, jobless man, but when it was Monday, they found me in my office as the manager. Why? The Lord God has touched me. Remember me. La satarabalaba. We are not faking it. We are not faking it. We are standing upon the wall. We are standing. Oh! Earthquake! 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 Of remembrance! Maybe some people still have their own prayer request to this ark of testimony. I'm going to pray for everybody here this morning for a touch of the Lord. Everybody, I'm going to pray for you that everyone that the enemy has mocked, as the hand of the Lord comes upon you tomorrow after the end of the Sabbath, today, this week, this month, is your own tongue of testimony. You are living from your land of mockery into your land of testimony. Welcome. Welcome to your season of remembrance. Welcome. As from today, where they have mocked you, today we congratulate you. Today we congratulate you. So I'm just going to congratulate everybody. As I congratulate you, settle it in your spirit that when people are mocking me, God is congratulating me in the name of Jesus. No more mockery. Mockery comes to an end. Mockery comes to an end in your life. I said mockery comes to your end. Mockery comes to an end in your life. No more mockery in your life. Congratulations. 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 No more mockery. No more mockery. No more mockery. No more mockery in your life. No more mockery. No more mockery in your life. Congratulations. I said no more mockery. No more mockery. No more mockery. No more mockery. There is no more mockery in your life. There is no more mockery. There is no more mockery in your life. Congratulations, there is no more mockery. No more mockery in your life. There is no more mockery. There is no more mockery. Mockery comes to an end. Enjoy your testimony. Enter into your testimony. Enter into your testimony. Enter into your testimony. No more mockery. No more mockery of enemy. No more mockery of Satan. Enter into your own testimony. Move into your own testimony. No more mockery of Satan. No more mockery. No more mockery of the word. Enter into your own testimony. In the mighty name of Jesus, I decree, I declare. No more mockery. No more mockery in my life. No more mockery. Forget to pray for yourself. No more mockery. No more mockery in my life. I enter into a realm of testimony. I enter into a realm of testimony. I enter into a realm of testimony. No more mockery. No more mockery. No more mockery. Enjoy the testimony of the Lord. Enjoy the testimony of the Lord. Enjoy the testimony of the Lord. It is done. Please take your seat. It is done.